bro.
You trying to take it somewhere else, but somebody need to hear what Lil Big Nate talking about. So don't
it's never been theft and fraud of an election has never been this blatant and this obvious. 76 million Americans had their votes invalidated, including my son, who voted for the first time in this election. You think this is going to go by with just some niceties and some platitudes and some let's all move on from this? You're out your fucking mind, okay? People are sick of this shit. These motherfuckers are not going to stop till every one of our sons is in a dress, all right? They're not going to stop. They have made it abundantly clear. And it would seem that much of Black America is in tune and in step with this. I mean, granted, you know what's interesting? I read so many articles that said that if Trump receives 20% of the Black male vote, this would be a landslide of epic proportions. Not only did he receive 20%+ of the vote, he doubled his Black vote among Black women. Okay? Ruby Freeman, HUDservatives done content on her. She was in Georgia. She was a poll worker, her and her daughter. She talked about all the Black men and women who had voted for Trump and how she turned the votes around. Video of her actually taking Biden ballots and recounting them, thousands of them. The fraud is on fucking video, and it doesn't matter. This is what scares the hell out of me, all right? The fact that every single media platform is now culpable in this crime. There is not one, not even Fox News, stood up against what was going on. They all said there's nothing to see here. Look away. These ridiculous claims of fraud, you know, none of them have any standing. My fear is, what the fuck do they have planned for us? What do they have planned for us, for all of them to be involved in this? Even Fox News involved. What do they have planned for us? And niggas dancing in the fucking streets, grown Black men twerking because their Democrat fucking president got in. You're not men. You are fucking cowards. I have said from the first time I came up on these goddamn platforms 5 months ago, if you vote Democrat, you are little more than a Black man, a Black woman with a penis. That's all you are. That's all you are, sir. And I'll be glad to meet anyone, anywhere, who wants to debate this with
television. Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Right on fucking television.
Cult, to describe the Republican Party. That's a pretty strong word. Why do you think it's a cult?
You know, the definition of a cult, you think of Jonestown, right? You think of Ruby Ridge. It's systems where you have a strong leader who takes a position and says, this is what we're doing. And everybody just salutes and says, yes, sir, yes, ma'am, and does it. They stick together with whatever rules they've adopted. Rather, it does away with free thinking. It does away with individual people making individual decisions on the merits of the questions that are before them. And I think that's pretty much the definition of a cult, certainly a definition of what the Republican Party is now.
Would that be dangerous to our constitutional democracy?
I think it'd be terribly dangerous. The Republican Party today has taken on a lot of the trappings of an authoritarian state. They have a strong leader who dictates and doesn't tolerate dissent, who lies about election results, who attacks the practice of the free press, who wants to have judges who are going to, well, obviously both parties seem to want judges who are just going to do what they want them to do. But I think that if Republicans were to take control of the House, Senate, and the presidency, I think our whole constitutional democracy would be in serious danger.
What do you think?
Open your mind.